Morning, 47. Sully the Crusher Bowden is currently setting up one of his street fight events, riling up his fighters and taking illegal bets. The event takes place tomorrow night, so this is a perfect opportunity to get close. Good luck, 47.
I fell over because a homeless woman suddenly jumped up right in front of me.
You're hiding this hole with cut.
Listen here, pal.
Sir, I'm sorry. This is a restricted area. That's a good boy. No offense, but I hope I don't see you again.
What's that about? I'm gonna be rich. Get the hell out of here. I got this plan.
And it says I can make a lot of money with you.
That flyer they started handing out to the homeless really got them flowing in.
Yeah, but it creeps me out how they're different when they leave.
Yeah, I'd say they're different when they leave.
Come on.
You know what?
I think
no matter how well they pay.
No one is asking you to. You just need to keep track of the ones you do.
That is Sully Bowden, a.k.a. the Crusher. Middleweight champion with, let's say, a taste for sweat and blood. Target eliminated. Well done. Now find an exit. Your money is being transferred now. Welcome to Berlin, 47. Your target is currently on site conducting one of his special inspections after a whistleblower reported the club's many code violations. His escort, Marion Keane, happens to be the daughter of one of his victims. The clients have offered a bonus if she makes it through the night unharmed.
If you want to get through, I'm going to have to pat you down.
Even when you're on the guest list.
Nothing to worry about. It's simple protocol, sir.
You're good to go, sir. Thank you for your patience.
Did it call again?
Yeah, it's fine. I'm right there. Just waiting to make a little transaction of my own. Then I'll drop it off.
Yeah, I know. It's on the receipt, right?
Ring the doorbell at the drop-off. Wouldn't have killed the guy to meet me outside, but what the hell do I care, right? Listen, I don't want to be on the phone when my dealer shows. I'll talk to you later.
Break time.
Oh, thanks.
You should try this.
Oh. Oh? Thanks.
It's got a little kick to it.
mind if I do?
Just go easy, would you?
Who wants a taste? You? Go ahead.
Target eliminated. The fund is transferring payment as we speak. Now let's hope the fire exits are up to code 47. Good afternoon, 47. Welcome to Thornbridge Manor. Your targets are currently separated, each taking care of their task at hand. Mr. Rowe is currently serving tasters to Gregory Carlyle, trying to entice him to become a VIP customer of his twist on Nordic cuisine, whilst Mr. Burke is putting the final touches on the late Zachary Carlyle, salvaging any potential waste that Mr. Rowe might deem appropriate for human consumption. Be careful, 47. These men are truly diabolical.
Okay, drop it! Keep your heads down, guys!
Hello, sir.
That is Jack Rowe, a.k.a. Jacob Rowe, celebrity chef who has cashed in on the Nordic cuisine bandwagon and has succeeded. His recipes might be bold, but he is a charlatan, if there ever was one. That is Robert Burke, an embalmer for the mourners who can afford him. His actions to please Mr. Rowe's fiendish appetite make him an equally diabolical confederate. Don't be fooled by his appearance.
Target. Anyone ambitious of the target?